Hey, it's me again.
In this video, I'm gonna show you how I make BBR textures for CS2, and then I'll show you what I've made using your suggestions that you've left in the last video's comment section. The program that I use for BBR textures is called Adobe Substance Sampler. Now, believe me when I say that as someone who used to make textures manually, this program is like a godsend. Now, of course, there are free alternatives to this program like Materialize, but believe me when I say that nothing will ever come close to the quality and speed of the Substance Sampler. When making a texture, I usually choose between two options. Option A is making your own texture from a photo. Now you may think this is hard, but it's actually really easy in Substance Sampler. All you have to do is literally just drag the photo into the program and just let it work its magic. Then to make it tile, you drag this tool called Make It Tile, surprisingly, onto the texture, and on top of that you can use Scrub to delete some parts of your texture. My only problem with this method is that scale actually doesn't fit CSGO. Or CS2, whatever. Of course, you can fix this by scaling it down in game. Now, option B is even quicker than option A, and it's about using stylized materials in Substance Sampler. You can get this for free from Adobe itself. Even on a free trial, you can download like 50 of these materials, most of them being completely customizable. You can filter these by setting stylized right over here. And when I say customizable, I mean every detail. You can see that there is a seed option here, which changes the complete look of the texture sometimes. The only catch I found with this program is that sometimes the normal maps are inverted for some reason. This means that the places where there's supposed to be shadow, there's light, and vice versa. And since I have no idea how to fix it in the program, I use Materialize to flip the normal texture. When exporting, you only really need 6 channels for CS2, and those are ambient occlusion, height, metallic, roughness, normal, and base color. Now, as far as I know, CS2 doesn't support height mapping, but it's needed when you are blending two textures together. To see how your texture will look in game, you can turn off height mapping in Substance Sampler right here. And yeah, that's how I make textures. Now, some of you asked me to do textures for you using the 3-letter parallax effect, and so I did. Here's something I made in about an hour or so. I used AI to generate all that office furniture, and the rest of the textures was made using Substance Sampler. Now, after I've done all this, I've realized that the guy didn't want an office, but an office supply room. So I just switched around the furniture and this was the final result. I actually enjoyed making this a lot more because trying to make the shelves 3D was a lot of fun. I even tried to make the paper stacks appear 3D, but it's kinda hard to see anyways. I've done this by stretching out the things that are on the edge, basically resulting in this 3D looking effect. I've made another texture with this thing in mind, and this one has a more subtle parallax effect than the previous one. Now let's move on to the forest. For this, I made 7 different textures to blend with the ground. This is something that would take me hours prior to discovering this program. For which I used Subdivision, which I then proceeded to bake. I'd recommend baking it only after you made your adjustments using the displacement tool, because once you bake the ground, the displacement tool doesn't work on it. Now, of course, you can also make the adjustments manually, but the displacement tool is obviously better. Then I used different blend textures on different segments, and well, that was basically it. Now, let's move to the other request you guys gave me. In the previous video, I've said how the parallax mapping effect can be used to fake car interiors, and so I did just that. Honestly, I'm really proud how it turned out because I made it in like 5 minutes, so that's something. And I think it's a great improvement over the original Windows disk drive has. And it wasn't even that hard to make, honestly. It actually reminds me of the lights in Portal 2. Those actually use a similar effect, but it was in Source 1, which is honestly kind of impressive. And yeah, that's all from me today. If you like this kind of content, consider subscribing. Thanks for sticking by, and see ya.